Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, I am very grateful to the honorable members who have made their observation on the budget while taking the opportunity of making a few observations on it. Nobody can claim that this is a budget where there is no deficiency, that this is an embodiment of perfection, and it has been possible for us to do whatever is needed for the betterment of economic situation in the country. At the same time, it has been very correctly pointed out that in a situation like ours, the finance minister had little option, or rather very little space for accommodation, to provide a budget on the one hand, keeping his eyes on the need of growth, and on the other, to see that the peculiar economic situation which has been created as a result of constant demand does not deteriorate further. In view of that, it has been admitted by almost all the speakers, including the distinguished leaders of the opposition, that in increase of the order of 31% in the plan outlay would go a long way and would create an investment climate which would ultimately be beneficial for the country. Now, while making these observations, he expressed his doubt whether the unbridged gap on the revenue side would create further stability factor on the price front. Keeping in view the situation as it is today and the economic disciplines and various measures which we have resorted to, perhaps we can modestly claim, unless certain external factors come into the picture, it would be possible for us to maintain the price stability as it is today, and at the same time as it has been expressed by the finance minister in his speech, by reducing the taxes both on direct and indirect side, the total revenues of the country would not be reduced. It is no use suggesting that the budget is for the money bag and that the budget is full of concessions for monopoly houses. The budget is an instrument through which the government tries to control and regulate the economy of the country for the current year and in this year's budget also. Tax exercise has been made nothing more, nothing less. Therefore, to categorize it either as a budget of money bag or a budget for monopoly houses is perhaps incorrect. In fact, it reduces the taxes for various categories. One point has been raised by my honorable friend that the percentage of reduction of taxes in the lower income group are not adequate, while the percentages of reduction of taxes in the upper income group are more. In this connection, I would like to point out one aspect which should be kept in mind. If we come to a conclusion that taxation is the only instrument of doing away economic disparity, perhaps it would not be correct. There are certain other factors which must be taken into account in this respect. In a developing economy like ours, no doubt taxation is a very important instrument of doing away economic disparity, but at the same time, there are certain other factors which also contribute for making the desired goal, such as investment policy, industrial licensing policy, and there is no denying the fact that for the last few years, the government is trying to concentrate on those fronts. Therefore, when certain tax rates have been reduced, it would not be correct to come to a conclusion that we have given up our idea of doing away economic disparities which prevail in the society. I would like to submit that the basic objective of our taxation system is progression in the rate of taxes. Even in the present tax structure, as it has been pointed out by my honorable friend while making his justification for reduction, but on the wealth tax side, this does not find any justification. Some people may be wondering why we cannot have a higher percentage of taxes. Sir, from the experience that we have gained during all these years, it has been established that a higher rate tax at a certain stage becomes counterproductive. There is no denying the fact that the rate of tax for income of over 90% that does create distortion not only in one form but in many directions. That does not mean that if somebody has acquired income or wealth up to a certain level, he does not acquire wealth anymore. But what happens is that he does acquire wealth, but that wealth or income is not brought into the books as a result of which all such vulgar expenditure is going on. These is no denial of the fact that the operation of black money, which went on and which is still going on in the country, is the product to some extent of a system like this. Therefore, to ensure that we do not have increase in black money, the rates of direct taxes should go down.